What do you think about Puppy Linux versus SliTaz?
SliTaz sounds like a modern Looney Tunes character, not a Linux version. Puppy Linux is a playful upstart, but it is debatable as to whether or not it is anything serious.
What is the difference between the two?
SliTaz uses the OpenBox desktop and BusyBox. It has a GNU license.
Puppy Linux has a word processing application.
Other Linux OS versions have Libre Office.
How do Puppy and SliTaz compare to those versions?
SliTaz is considered one of the light Linux operating systems, using only 256 megabytes of RAM.
Puppy Linux only needs 85 megabytes.
That's 85 megabytes of hard disk space, and SliTaz is similar in memory space.
What difference does that make?
SliTaz can run from a CD Rom or USB key, but you can run it on an old PC too.
The light Linux instances are popular on refurbished PCs sold or donated to poor people.
SliTaz is better for most users than Puppy Linux, though.
You just said both use little memory and RAM.
But Puppy does not have as many tools many Linux users, would-be hackers or software developers, want. For example, SliTaz comes with SysLinux and more than 200 commands.
Not all users need that.
You get the SQLite database with SliTaz. And you get a lot of tools like the SSH client, an X Windows system and a sound file editor.
Yeah, I can see where having tools like that would be useful.
And Puppy has none of them, while it has less support online if you want to identify what versions of those tools you could install on your own system.
SliTaz is not much bigger in terms of user base.
SliTaz is in the 50s of Linux distributions, while Puppy is 11th. But that's still a fraction of the Mint and Ubuntu and Debian installs, so you should get the one with more features over a fad that's going to go away.
You want to put the puppy to sleep.
It is not the attack dog you think it is.